Tokyo Summer Olympics and Paralympics Living My Dream campaign has been made possible by the National Lotteries Commission and implemented by the Sports Trust. In this week's episode, we showcase the Tokyo 2020 Olympic and Paralympic athletes who were recently honored and rewarded for their medal achievements by the Department of Sport, Arts and Culture, the National Lotteries Commission, and SASCOC. The Living My Dream medal winners enjoyed celebrating their success in an open bus parade that started from the High Performance Center at TIX in Pretoria and culminated in the award ceremony later that evening in Johannesburg.
The South African Sports Confederation and Olympics Committee, SASCOC, has enjoyed a long relationship with the NLC directly through various federations. For many years, Minister, participating at the Olympic and Paralympic Games has been made possible by SASCOC, supported by the grants from partners organizations such as NLC. The same goes for the Sports Trust. Over the years, we have directed millions towards their programs to ensure that athletes are able to train and compete to their full potential. Our commitment to see you living your dream is consistent in the years between the Olympics as you train, compete, push yourselves to the limits. It is that same commitment that sees us supporting various federations, schools across the nation to unearth the next Ntando Mahlangu, the next Dandan Schoolman. In the build-up to the Tokyo Games, we received many messages from athletes like Zanele Situ, Peter Dupres, Wayne Van Nicker, Sharon James, the Blitz Bob, and several others, all thanking the NLC for supporting them in the quest to live their dream.
It really means a lot to me that the government and that the NLC and the Sports Trust is coming together and they're celebrating us with friends and family, and it's really heartwarming to just experience the love from friends and family, but also from people who become like your friends and family, like SASCOC's every single person at SASCOC who has done so much for us, coaches, the media even start to feel like your friends because you see them and they support us, and just everybody, like guides. Exciting, I've never been on a boarding bus, so that was quite cool. Very, very nice.
28 years of age, silver in the 1500 meters. He's going to pick up bronze in the women's marathon. There is Luzanne Kurtier of South Africa. She picked up the bronze medal, but she's a T11 athlete.
I'm very privileged to be a guide for Luzanne Kurtier. In the marathon the T11 marathons. They normally say a marathon starts at about 32 kilometers with 10 k's to go, and that was basically the time when we realized that we have an opportunity to take a spot on the podium, and we had a goosebumps moment, and we never hit a real wall, and then it just continued for up until the end, up until we went for the 600 in the stadium. So it was a wonderful goosebump, long 10 kilometers.
It is net wow. Ek kan dit nou nog nie glo nie. Partykeer is dit soos in, dit kan nie waar wees nie. Ons is reg vir 2024. Ons gaan vir goud. Ons gaan hard oefen. En sy en haar gidse glo. Sy kan nog hoër hoogtes bereik.
And it's Cheryl James of South Africa, who picks up a bronze medal to add to her bronze back in the Worlds in 2019.
Oh, no, it's a great honor. It's a great celebration of what South Africa has done, and I was part of it. Celebrated it with my family, had a huge celebration when I went home. The people back home loved it and just enjoyed sharing the moment with me. It was great.
I was thinking of all those times that we were training and preparing for that last home straight. I knew she had it in herself, I know what we had put into it, so I believed in her all along, and I'm just happy that she could pull it off. I think it's very, it's a lot of pressure they are under, and to keep it all together all the way and not to fall under the pressure, I think she's managed to do that well.
And then we got Baitendock coming away from South Africa representing and getting that silver medal, taking care of business with the silver.
There was a lack of words. I think just emotions overwhelmed me completely, and it was just tears and gratitude and pride to be South African and to be able to represent such a beautiful country. If I was a little girl thinking that I would be standing here tonight, I wouldn't believe myself. So it means a lot, not only for me, but my family and community, and yeah, for the sport of surfing. It's beyond measure.
Peter Dupreer of South Africa is storming along here in a superb performance. The men's H1 time trial won by Pieter Dupreer of South Africa.
It's an absolute privilege. You know, we know each other by now, and it's just so great to share, you know, this journey that we've been on and to share it with South Africa. And, I mean, that's the thing, it's not just about the medalists, it's about everybody that took part. And it really, for me, I think all of the medals feel the same. It's not our individual medals, it's the country's medals and everybody on the journey. And I mean, right now it just feels like the whole country was on the journey with us. You know, after such a long time and many struggles and fights and the hard work and coming back, and I mean, that's when it really sunk in. And I mean, the tears were flowing on in that moment. You know, it's especially really so great to be able to share it with the community who sees you train every day.
But it is South Africa's Arune Veyers who's going to take the win in a time of 56.05 seconds.
It's a great honor that we are acknowledged and we can celebrate our journeys together, and we're having this event with Olympians and knowing their stories that was shared across Instagram and Facebook was quite special. Not just the beautiful moments, but the challenging moments we all went through. And I think also part of the emotions is knowing we all have our beautiful stories, and to celebrate that together at this event, I'm really grateful for. So, like I again said, I'm really grateful for the Sport Trust and the NLC and SASCOC and everybody that's making sure that this event is able to go and do and celebrate us. And then obviously, it was very emotional up there, but I think it's just the, I said before the games that I wanted to just run with God, and this medal is a celebration and a platform to just celebrate what he's done in my life. And that's just great. I'm very grateful, a lot of gratitude towards what God has done in my life on the sporting field. And it's really an honor just to be here tonight and to celebrate every athlete.
Yeah, all the memories and all the journeys and all the connections of those that you made in Tokyo really come to the fore. It makes you realize how privileged and special the time in Tokyo was. I think for me tonight is a celebration of Tokyo. With the hashtag United by Emotion, the hashtag of South Africa, bring Ubuntu back. I think those words are really, for me, what tonight is also about. So how does it feel to be like extension of Tokyo, and to really be grateful for that opportunities that we had and to share. And to see Andrew's race is the first time I saw it, not in life, but in watching it. And I think it takes you back into that, or took me back now, into that moment and the deep appreciation of a long journey.
2:18.95 is a world record and gold for South Africa for Tatiana Schoenmaker. She can barely believe what she's just done.
Very special, I think, especially because it's for me exactly 2 months ago, so I think it makes the moment extra special, and just to receive the support and celebrate each other's victories and stuff is amazing. And yeah, we wish all the Olympians could be here because they all did amazingly, but it is very special. Just to say thank you, and if I didn't get you to say thank you, because it's just been overwhelming, like all the thank yous and the support, and so yeah, just to say thank you and really believe in yourself. We were there to prove that you can, and so we just wanted to create that little bit of hope and that little bit of inspiration, and just to say that you can also do it. And I mean, even for the Paralympic athletes, to prove disability doesn't hold you back, and that they've achieved that, like, amazing achievements over their disabilities.
This is huge. He's 7:17. He's taken the lead, a world record for Maklangu. The man out of Pretoria.
But I have to give this one to my coaches. I think, you know, in the long jump, Coach Neil had my back a lot. In the 200s, you know, I was very sore after the long jump. So, you know, Coach Cathy was also looking good care of me. I think if I didn't have the two coaches, I wouldn't have got this opportunity. But, you know, this one has to be dedicated to the coaches because, you know, sometimes we don't thank them a lot. But, you know, behind the work, they do a lot of work behind the scenes.
They've done us proud, and we strive to be a winning nation. And for us to be a winning nation, those who are doing the actual work should feel that we recognize them. And the incentives are meant to encourage them even more to do better than what they did this time around, to encourage others who couldn't reach the point they reached so that they know that they have a place. They have a place, whatever resources we can master as government, we'll continue to do that so that we really reach our point of being a winning nation. The honor is theirs tonight.
The Sports Trust wishes to thank the National Lotteries Commission, who had provided key funding that ensured that these SA Olympic and Paralympic medal hopefuls, as identified and selected by SASCOC, were able to live their dream and achieve their lifelong goals at the 2020 Tokyo Summer Games.
Part of the fourth challenge of the Nedbank Runified series, which is this 10 kilometers between the 16th to the 29th of October. It is a cumulative, as we call it, whereby all you have to do is run 10 kilometers within this 2-week period. You only have to do it once, or you can do it all in one go. And you don't have to run 10 kilometers every single day. So you can run from wherever you are, at your own pace, your own leisure. And once you've completed this challenge, there'll be a registration link whereby you fill in all your details, stand a chance of winning great prizes, and earn your Nedbank Runified Strava badge. And at the end, of course, you have an opportunity to also donate to the Sports Trust to support our Nedbank Running Development Program.
Join us for this year's Nedbank Sports Trust Community Cycle Challenge. Be a hero and cycle for our communities on the 30th and 31st of October. This challenge is free for everyone to enjoy. Join the Nedbank Sports Trust Cycling Club on Strava. Please kindly make a donation on www.cricket.co.za. On the Nedbank Sports Trust Virtual Cycle Challenge, all donations go to the development of a new BMX bike park in Pickettburg. Stand a chance to win some lucky draw prizes sponsored by Disfruta Sports Tours when you share your images from your cycle challenge using hashtag SDEuro or SDCycle. Tag us on Strava and our social media platforms at Sports Trust SA. These prizes include a helmet from Equay Corsa Evo 2019 valued at 1,999 Rand. Two entries to the Cape Town Cycle Tour in 2022. Terms and conditions will apply.